What's up, everybody? So we are going to analyze one of the greatest shot putters of all time. I would say one of the most consistent shot putters of all time. World champion Reese Hoffa. This is in the 2012 Olympics, and this is, you know, Reese got the Olympic bronze here. I remember watching this, you know, sitting there, it was like 5 in the morning, just watching and waiting for Reese to really, really go off. We never really hit that monster throw. I think this was, 21-30, somewhere around there. But let's just watch and see. There's Don Babbitt right there. Let's watch and see and take in, you know, his amazing, you know, feat. Top three at the Olympics.
Managed 21.23 with his third throw. Enough to earn him the bronze medal.
So 21.23. So let's see. You know, couple things to look at is, you know, that different turn he's got out of the back. Opens up his left. I felt like in this throw, compared to some of his other throws, what I did want to point out is where his left foot is here when he picks up. That's something that we can all really, you know, take away. And if you watch somebody like Kovacs or Krauser, they do almost the exact same thing, where this left opens past 90 while his right stays down. That gives him this nice spread between the knees. I felt like he was falling in a hair more than normal back when I watched. And his right leg here, if you watch when he won in 07, was in a little bit different position because his hips are falling in here, whereas in 07 when he wins, his hips are more over top of that left foot. Right ground's a good spot. One of the things I want everybody to pay attention to is that's where his right grounds, right? So his right foot grounds there. Look at the speed of his left leg, how quickly it's coming around. Grounds the right. This comes around rapidly. Look at the height of that left leg, okay? Look at the width between the left knee and the right knee here, similar to Walsh, similar to Kovacs. I do think, too, because he sort of falls in out of the back, that his position here is a little bit sort of exposed. Instead of in 07, he was a little bit more upright over top of that right side. So his right side rotated a little bit better in 07. Left grounds, he's opening that left arm wide. He starts to lift early off that left leg as well. You know, the shot's there. If you watch the 07 throw, he's grounded a little bit longer and he rotates a little bit better. You can see here, like, this is not a typical Hoffa finish where his right leg sort of like flails to the right and he's really, really jumpy here. This isn't his standard, you know, finish. If you compare his Osaka throw, you can really see that difference. So again, dude, he gets third at the Olympics. So it's one of those things. He's thrown 190 times. He's one of the best ever. I'm not taking anything away from him. I'm just trying to figure out the difference here then in relative comparison to his best throw in Osaka. So that's Reese Hoffa's 2008 Olympic bronze throw.
1.23 with his third throw.
He's a little more off balance out of the back. He still gets a good hit on it. He's a little jumpier on the finish, but what we can take away is being patient out of the back here in double support, coming around that left side, having a super quick left leg, that left knee getting in front of the right knee pretty deep, and then trying to stay grounded a little bit longer to ensure a much better finish. So if you guys like these analyses, head over to throwsuniversity.com. You can pick up a technical analysis today. Until next time, peace.